much of what we experience in life comes out of really ancient parts of the nervous system, what's called the brain stem. And that information is taken from the whole body. That information comes up. It's what's called the bottom-up approach to behavior. We experience it through our cortical pathways and through life's experiences, which are sort of stored in the cortex. But the information itself is very nonspecific. It's vague. In fact, it comes through a nerve called the vagus. The vagus nerve predates mammals, and some components of it go all the way back to fish or the ancestors of fish. So we have this really ancient information coming up into our brain, into our consciousness. We interpret it as feeling safe or feeling afraid. Those are sort of the most two fundamental states that almost all vertebrates, all mammals experience. That information has a tremendous impact on whether we can think or not, whether we can think straight, whether we can make rational decisions, whether we can interpret the environment in an accurate way. Psychologists have spent 40, 50, maybe longer years arguing about different emotions. In some ways, it doesn't matter, the really sort of two fundamental patterns. There's a pattern of safety, security, and in that state, we have much more touch with constructs or feelings like compassion, empathy, awareness of the feelings of others. Older states, which actually have very specific physiology that's now known, these older states are much more primitive. They may allow us, or they may, under the conditions of sort of these ancient systems associated with fear, we may see everything around us as fearful. We may not be able to engage in positive behaviors because we're so busy defending ourselves. Anything we can do to provide that child with a sense of safety is positive. That safety might come from an outsider to the family who's available for the child to call, to go to that person. In earlier times, it might have been a grandparent. It might be an aunt or an uncle, but it doesn't have to be a family member. It only has to be someone who themselves are sufficiently safe that they can provide what used to be called a secure base. The quality of that care has an immediate effect on how a child reacts to the environment. If you go to someone who makes you feel safe, your state can change instantly. You can be taken out of these fear states into a sense of safety because humans are so social. UNICEF is already in the business of creating safety, and what this conference brings to it is a sense of how important the biological states are to these decisions.